It is now the 10th day of Mauna Loa's ongoing eruption, and in the past 48 hours, the lava fountaining at Fissure 3 has created increasingly tall fountains when compared to previous days. For example, on November 29th, lava fountains from Fissure 3 were measured by the US Geological Survey as up to 82 feet or 25 meters in height. However, on December 5th, the US Geological Survey found that bursts of activity were sending fragments of lava up to 330 feet or 100 meters in height. Meanwhile, the northernmost lava flow, which now has a length of 11.8 miles from Fissure 3, is 1.93 miles or 3.1 kilometers away from a major road on the Big Island. Per the US Geological Survey, during the last 24 hours from a period spanning sections of December 5th and December 6th, the lava flow advanced at a speed of between 62 and 90 feet per hour. Although the speed of the lava flow has been highly variable as of late, if it were to continue advancing at its latest measured range of advance, it would begin flowing onto the road sometime between the morning of December 9th and December 11th. If this were to occur, there is a possibility that advancing lava would hit long-extinct cinder cones, which could act as a temporary barrier despite being incomplete, and direct some of the lava to the west. Or, the lava flow could simply go around the cones and hit the road in several locations, assuming that the eruption continues for at least another week. Speaking of cinder cones, the ongoing eruption of Mauna Loa is building an elongated spatter cone rather than a cinder cone. So, what is the difference between these two similarly looking volcanic cones? Cinder cones are medium-sized volcanic cones which are composed primarily out of scoria, ash, and small bombs of lava ejected in mildly explosive eruptions. On the other hand, spatter cones are composed almost completely out of lava and form at vents during eruptions with either no or only a very minimal explosive component. Although spatter cones can be quite large, they tend to be a fraction of the size of the largest cinder cones. If a noticeable amount of ash is being emitted from an erupting isolated volcanic cone, it is likely a cinder cone. On the other hand, if an eruption produces a negligible amount or no ash from an isolated vent and significant quantities of lava, then the erupting vent is likely a spatter cone. On the Big Island, both types of vents can be found at various shield volcanoes. Cinder cones tend to form during more gas-rich eruptions, while spatter cones form during more gas-poor eruptions. On December 5th, the US Geological Survey posted their latest estimate on the amount of land which has been covered by lava. They produced a figure of 13.6 square miles or 35.22 square kilometers. Although they did not make an official statement on this, I extrapolated the prior area figure to estimate how much total lava has erupted, reaching a guess of around 158 million cubic meters of material. This area is no longer expanding substantially, but will continue to increase in oncoming days. A secondary piece of evidence that the rate of lava fusion is decreasing relates to the amount of sulfur dioxide which Mauna Loa's active vent and lava flows have produced each day. Whereas on November 28th, Mauna Loa was releasing 250,000 tons of sulfur dioxide a day, on December 2nd, this figure decreased to 180,000 tons a day, and on December 4th, this figure decreased further to 120,000 tons a day. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's top supporters on YouTube via YouTube members and patrons on Patreon.